Huawei has finally ripped back the curtain on its sexy new P30 smartphone family, and the P30 Pro is definitely the Billy Big Bollocks model of the bunch. We went hands-on ahead of the official launch in order to bring you this first impressions review, and don't forget for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech to poke subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Cheers. Now first of all, there's no denying the Huawei P30 Pro is an absolute beaut, even though it rocks a very similar curved glass design to last year's P20 Pro. It seems a little bit slimmer in our hands-on time, and definitely a little bit bigger as well. It's a 6.47 inch device now. You can grab the P30 Pro in a selection of 5 different colours. You've got pearl white, which looks very neat, and your bog standard black, and you've also got a selection of the gradient colours as well, the breathing crystal and the Aurora model, which looks very similar to last year's P20 Pro Aurora Effort. Our favourite is definitely the amber sunrise, which unfortunately we couldn't go hands on with, but it's a lovely deep rich red colour, which again sports that gradient style finish. And the good news for clumsy oafs like myself is the fact that the P30 Pro sports full dust and water IP68 resistance. Now flip around to the front, you get that mighty 6.47 inch OLED display. It pretty much fills the phone edge to edge, unlike last year's model, which of course rocked the fingerprint sensor beneath the display. You now actually get an in-screen fingerprint sensor. It's just an optical model rather than the ultrasonic effort that you got on the likes of Samsung's Galaxy S10 smartphones, but it certainly seemed very quick and responsive in our hands-on time, probably better even than the Mate 20 Pro's effort. Back to the screen tech itself though, it's an OLED panel, it's full HD plus, so it's not a quad HD model, but you know what? Still perfectly crisp and super punchy colours as well, which again can be scaled back in the display settings if you like. It's fully HDR ready as you would expect these days, so the likes of Netflix and stuff, you'll be able to stream that HDR content with great looking contrast and realistic colours. And it's a 19.5:9 aspect ratio as well. The notch has definitely been scaled back from last year's P20 Pro as well. It's just a dewdrop little effort, barely even noticeable at the top, and you can mask it from view in the settings if you like. If you're particularly observant, you'll also notice that there is no top speaker on the Huawei P30 Pro. That's because it uses electromagnetic levitation. This is basically a vibration system, so the screen will vibrate to produce that audio when you're in a call. However, for your media, the sound will only be pumped out of the bottom-mounted speaker. The software is, as you would expect, Android 9, the latest version, with a nice bit of EMUI 9.1, again the latest version, slapped on top. This adds all kinds of bonus functionality, most of which we've already seen on the Mate 20 Pro. You get the likes of your face unlock, your digital well-being nanny, lots of gesture support, the works. And of course it also supports Huawei's new One Hop system, so if you've got a Huawei MateBook laptop for instance, you'll be able to quickly share files just like you can with the likes of the AirDrop on your Apple devices. Running the show is a Kirin 980 chipset backed here by 8 GB of RAM. It certainly seems silky smooth in our hands-on time, again just like the Mate 20 Pro before it. And if you like downloading a lot of movies, games, things like that, then no worries whatsoever. Our demo model of the P30 Pro came with 256 GB of storage on board, and we couldn't confirm whether there was support for Huawei's proprietary memory card or not. Unfortunately, they couldn't tell us that at our demo session, but fingers crossed it does support that as well. Now onto the battery tech, and you get a mighty 4,200 milliamp cells stuffed inside this beast. So the Huawei P30 Pro should easily keep you going all day long, hopefully well into 2 days as well. The good news is that it also supports the 40-watt supercharge that we saw on the Mate 20 Pro before it, and you get the full 15-watt wireless charging as well, and yes, a good bit of reverse wireless charging as well, so you can share the P30 Pro's battery life with whatever other wireless charging gizmos you have. But of course, the main emphasis of the Huawei P30 Pro is the photography chops as well, and it certainly doesn't seem to disappoint in that regard. It's a step up even from the Mate 20 Pro's tri-lens setup. What you get on the P30 Pro is actually a quad lens design. So you've got a 40 megapixel primary lens, f1.6, with optical image stabilization built in. This is very different from the Mate 20 Pro's 40 megapixel RGB lens, however, as it uses Huawei's new super spectrum design. Instead of soaking up RGB light, this soaks up RYYB light, basically red, yellow, blue instead. There's a whole load of technical gumph behind all of this, but the upshot is that basically that means the sensor can absorb extra light compared with previous efforts. That should hopefully mean that, along with the increased aperture size, you get some really high light sensitivity, which means impressive details during the day, really nice, rich, natural colours, and of course, better looking night shots as well. The secondary lens is a 20 megapixel ultra wide lens with f2.2 aperture, and thirdly, the more interesting one, is the 8 megapixel optical periscope zoom. And this gives you a 5x optical zoom, as well as up to a 10x hybrid zoom. And that's a clear step up over the likes of the Mate 20 Pro, which should mean you can get some really nice crisp shots of a distant subject. Now both the primary lens and that third periscope zoom lens both boast a bit of optical image stabilization as well. And fourthly, because this is a quad lens setup now, you get a time of flight lens as well, which can accurately measure distances between you and any subject. This can be used to produce some really nice accurate bokeh in your portrait shots, and can also be used for AR circumstances as well to accurately measure distances. Dive on into that camera app, and it has basically changed up very little compared with the likes of the Mate 20 Pro, the P20 Pro before it. You still get a buttload of bonus features if you want them, but what you do get now as well is a super HDR shot mode, which is AI driven. This can just help to limit the amount of saturation you find on brighter elements in your shots, such as sunlight, while also keeping your subject, such as a person in shot, nice and crisp, and just brightening them up a bit to make them more detailed. There's also a new dual view video shot mode as well, which can use a couple of those lenses at once and shoot a side-by-side image, one superimposed on top of the other, but this won't apparently be available at launch. It'll come available at an over-the-air update. And as for the video chops, you can shoot up to 4K resolution video, which should look better at night thanks to, again, that higher aperture and, of course, the funky super spectrum design. Swap around to the front-facing camera. It's a 32 megapixel snapper with super HDR chops again, and that super low light feature as well. You get full portrait mode support as well, of course. So certainly a lot to be excited about with the Huawei P30 Pro. It looks like a very professional bit of kit, certainly very strong photo and video chops, and it looks like the rest of the tech can more than keep up as well. So let us know what you think down in the comments below. Stay tuned for more of our in-depth coverage. We'll be getting our full review device very shortly, so we'll be bringing you a full camera review and an in-depth review of the phone itself as well. And don't forget to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest tech. Cheers, everyone. Love you.